Heartless, harsh and lacking in mana and dignity. That's how the Ombudsman describes the beleaguered managed isolation system and the government department in charge of handling it. Hundreds of people complained to the Ombudsman about MIQ, detailing heartbreaking tales of missed opportunities and trauma. Here's business correspondent Katie Bradford.
For 2 years, we heard heartbreaking stories of medical emergencies.
It's almost like they've gone out of their way to sort of inflict harm.
Every day I'm in here, it's a day lost without my mum.
Of split families and missed moments.
When I left her, she was just 8 years old and now she is 10.
It's just a memory that I'll never have, I guess.
I miss home.
And now the Ombudsman has found the MIQ system failed Kiwis. He says it wasn't MIQ itself that was heartless, but the human lottery those desperate to come home had to win.
It was unfair and unreasonable. In devising a system where there was no priority, no weighting of individual circumstance, it operated very, very harshly to a number of New Zealanders.
Reading his words has brought relief for the founder of lobby group Grounded Kiwis.
I actually felt sick to my stomach.
From her London home, she's spoken to those still dealing with the traumatic memories of trying to get home to New Zealand.
It's a collective wow. You know, I had a message from someone that said, you know, I love Peter Boshier because finally they feel that there's someone that has really understood what they went through and is saying that something needs to be done about this.
Put simply, the ministry in charge lost sight of the people it was supposed to be helping. 230,000 people made an MIQ facility their temporary home, and MB says it succeeded in stopping nearly 5,000 cases of COVID. But Peter Boshier says MB needs to consider apologies and look at every single one of the 270 complaints he dealt with individually.
They need to have closure and a sense of justice and fairness, and I would hope that MB will see that for some an apology should be given.
MB admits the system wasn't perfect and it dropped the ball when it came to treaty obligations and disabled people. As for any apologies, it says those may happen in appropriate circumstances, and depending what the Ombudsman says next, some personal apologies could be on the way. Sorry seems to be the hardest word for the Prime Minister today.
Yes, impacted negatively, we've always acknowledged that, but we also, on the flip side, only did those things in order to save lives.
This personal apology should be delivered to those who complain and to the wider New Zealand public. The government got this wrong.
MB says it's working on changes should MIQ be needed again. The Ombudsman hoping all government departments learn that they too must have a heart. Katie Bradford, One News.